Okay, let's now do an Apex example. And quite a common use case here is, say your boss wants a new button on a page and is not really happy with the default style of the button. And they say, oh, just go out to the internet and find something that looks better, sexier, cooler, and all that sort of stuff. Okay, so let's see how, from a fairly high level, how you would approach that. All right, so let's get back into the browser, and let's put this down here. And you can see, okay, your boss has said, okay, let's add a button here. And I've already taken the liberty of actually putting a button up here. Of course, this button, if you click on it, does nothing. It's just a button. And your boss says, oh, I'm glad the button's there, but now it looks kind of bland. And he says, well, my daughter has got to put her own website up, and it's being hosted by GoDaddy, and they have real cool green buttons, and I'd like a nice GoDaddy button here. So what you can do is go to someplace like GoDaddy here, and you can see that they've got a nice looking green button here. And so if you want to bring this button into Apex, how do you go about approaching that problem? Well, one of the first things you want to do is come to the GoDaddy button, simply right-click on it. Inspect element. There you go. And now we can see over on the HTML side, it's automatically highlighted for us. We can see that that button is really not a button. It is actually, in fact, an anchor tag. So that is good information to get. And, you know, these IDs and classes here are, of course, specific to GoDaddy, so you're not too worried about that. But what you want to do is actually have a look at the styling over here, because fundamentally what you want to do is copy the styling from here into Apex. And so what you do is you start clicking on these check marks. You see that minimum width does have an effect. And you go and one at a time just go through some of these things. The alignment of the text goes from center if you click that off, so that seems to be important. You go through the styling elements here and figure out what's important to you. Okay, that block stuff seems important. The background color, of course, is important. You keep on going, and you see down here the border bottom. If you click that off, you see that that little underline at the bottom of the button goes away if you click that off. So that's fairly important. So what you do here is once you find out what's important, you can highlight all of this and copy it somewhere to a text file. And of course, I've already done that. I just don't want to do the details here for you, just showing you the overall general approach. So you come here, you find out what the styling is, and then you go back to Apex, and you look at your Apex button, and you go, okay, well, I've got this GoDaddy styling. How do I get it inside Apex? And one of the first things you can do, of course, is right-click on your Apex button and inspect the element and have a quick look at it. And here you see, instead of a reference, you've actually got a span tag here that's surrounding the text. That might be useful, it might not be, but that's good information to have. But you actually see that the button itself, just like the GoDaddy button, is an anchor tag. So, hey, this is an indication that we're probably in pretty good shape here for pulling that in. And here in this case, you really don't care about the style, is because you really want to replace the style. Now, where do you go to replace the style? Okay, well, let's have a look at the button here. Let's put the developer tool down. Now, let's look at the button itself. Okay, so we'll go into the Apex development environment. Let me just make this just a bit bigger. There we go. So we go and edit the page. Let's double-click on the button. And what we want to do here is maybe let's look at the attributes to find out a little more about this button. The style is template-based. That gives us some information. And it's using a template called button. So that's where the stylings come from. Okay, so let's go into shared components. And that's where the templates live. And here under user interface tab, we have a link here called templates. So let's drill in there. And let's filter this by the let's filter this by the type of button, so this is already pre-selected for us. I did that earlier today. And so we can see that there's our template button. So let's click on that and see what we've got here. And the interesting stuff, of course, is in the definition. And we can see here is where our anchor tag is actually, in fact, defined. And you see it's an href class, blah, 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 and here's the span, and there's the label that got substitution variable here. Okay, so that looks pretty straightforward. Now, since this is just HTML, it is quite possible for us to actually add a style tag. But we don't want to do it here because this particular template is probably used in many other places in our application, so we don't want to break the entire application. So a way to approach this is to actually create a copy of this template and then customize it. And you can see over here on this report, you can see this copy icon. And so if you press that, you can actually make a faithful copy of your template, which is what I did earlier. And here I've got this, I created this button, My Green. Let's click on that and see what I did. So if we go into the definition, let's see if I can drag that down a bit. That's a bit small. So what I'm going to do here is just, highlight that. Let's control C that. I'm going to put this tag into Notepad++. There we go. Okay, so this is what I did to my custom template. Down here, I've left the old syntax here. You can see that we've got this original code, and I've commented that out. And it is of class UButton. And over here, you can see that there's that span tag. So what I've done here is I've actually changed that. And I've actually created another class here called my_uButton. And I've actually defined that up here in this particular style tag that I've actually added to this template. And then all of these mid-width, these CSS properties, this is what I copied in from the GoDaddy site. Okay, and then what I did over here too is I found that the span tag here really wasn't all that useful. So I simply took it out. So now we have this redefined template with all of this code in. Let's just minimize that now. Let's go back to our Apex. And so what we need to do now is go back to our application, go to our page 2, go into our button, and go to the Attributes tab, change the template from button to My Button, My Green, that's the one I just created, and apply changes. If I run this, I get this GoDaddy button embedded into my Apex application.